And welcome back to the Intel Extreme Masters World Championship. It is the final game of Group B. We're about to find out whether Fnatic or the Xiaogu Reapers will be advancing to the semi-final. Deficio has put me up to what I'm about to say. He convinced me to do this.
I have not said this at all.
Europe's number 5 team has already knocked out North America's number 2 team and one of the favorites, or one of the considered favorites coming into the tournament. They are on the verge of knocking out a team that was, until last week, China's number 1 team.
You're so biased, Trevor.
Now, he made me say that. I would like to put that out there.
So biased, Trevor.
Thank you to everybody in the audience that is clapping.
Right.
It has been
right.
a just, very long
just,
day.
Just calm down, boys. Take your victories while you can, while Korea's number 6 team rolls everybody without losing a game.
Former world champion team, move on.
Yep. Yeah, it's kind of heartbreaking, isn't it?
A little bit.
It is kind of heartbreaking. So, let's get back on track. Fnatic won in 27 minutes. It was quicker than QG's win, which means they got choice of sides. They elected to take blue side, like they did in game 2 where they won.
Yep.
And they confused the hell out of us because they went Nautilus first pick, Killista went unpicked, there was all those mind games. Can they do it again as we're about to jump into picks and bans?
Well, here's the funny thing, because you would assume Fnatic wants to mirror the last pick and ban phase, first pick Nautilus, but if Jhin gets banned instead of Nidalee from QG, which I think they should do, suddenly that Killista actually has a lot of value again and might be the first pick, and then Nautilus goes over to QG's side, and that's been a good pick for Gamzo, who's been playing, honestly, a great tournament so far on these two tanks up top, Nautilus and Rammus.
Well, we'll find out what the teams decide to do. There is a pivot in the ban strategy. It is Quinn instead of maybe that
yeah.
Jhin.
Actually, don't ban the Rammus anymore, because he's been playing so well on Nautilus anyway. So just remove that one. I'd say Quinn is still a good ban, and also Jhin is the last one I'm looking at coming in from QG, unless they feel like they can play against it now, and then they want to try another time.
Actually, quite surprised to see the Lissandra ban. I know they banned it last game too, but it's worth noting that Dornby has only played Lissandra this year at this tournament. He's played almost exclusively Victor and LeBlanc back in the LPL, and it will be a Lulu.
Interesting. They do give over the Jhin again, and that means Fnatic won't first pick Killista because we are in exactly the same setup as before. But QG said we will not pick it because of Jhin. I still think you can. I don't think it's like, oh my god, Killista is useless just because Jhin is here. And yeah. Uzi is a fantastic Killista player, and it works so well in these team fights when you have so much synergy taking in your support, because again, Alistar is there for your support. I think it's good. Just take Alistar here in a jungler and then take Killista potentially next rotation.
You mean like Alistar Gragas?
I think that's a fine rotation, yeah.
All right, we'll find out. 20 seconds left. I'm not getting baited
how
this time.
Precious.
Oh, can you see the future?
Shot.
Right, who is going to be the first team to make a change? Because we got very surprised in game 2 when we were contrasting Fnatic versus QG from much earlier in the day. Ooh. It will be a pivot and it will be Swift on that Rek'Sai. What do you make of that change, Monty?
I'm not quite sure what to make of that change in this particular situation. I think that Swift's problems came from mostly decision-making, not the champion, in that last game. And you would think that you would want to have the more disruptive playmaking Gragas. Rek'Sai is just not as strong in the current meta.
So here's the way I look at this pick. First of all, it's a comfort pick for Swift. It's his most played jungler, and he likes to like farm a lot on it and get into team fights and be very tanky with Cinderhold. Because they expected Lee Sin to be the pick from Spirit, I think that's why they went for Rek'Sai. Try and match a bit of the early aggression coming in, and also if you can knock up that Lee Sin when he tries to come in and insect your AD carry with the Rek'Sai, you can disrupt it. I feel like it's purely a pick against the Lee Sin. I still think Gragas is better just overall, but Swift likes this very farm-heavy style on a Rek'Sai.
Swift could have taken the Lee Sin.
He could also just have taken
it. I don't really buy that, because yeah. I mean, you could absolutely just take the Lee Sin in that particular situation. But if we're going to see this Rek'Sai, maybe they're going to be looking for some of this split pushing with the Tremor Sense, or trying to get a better just read on where people are going to be on the map. It will be the Fiora again, this time the LeBlanc coming through blind for Dornby.
So just throwing it out there, Pippen is a great Zed player, and you could opt into that matchup. It would probably require a Corki pick then for some magic damage, so I don't think Fnatic is going to go for it. But taking away LeBlanc is actually super smart. Pippen has been showing up on this champion, and Quinn has been banned away, and no more Victor shenanigans here as the last pick where you just lose the map around it from QG.
I think the Jhin's just going to come in again, because otherwise we're basically waiting for that last pick of an AD carry.
Yeah, it has to be Jhin, by the way, because otherwise Kalista comes in on the other side.
Yep.
Ooh, it's not a Zed, but I like it as well. Match. Oh, it is actually a Zed. I can't believe I actually said that.
You get a high five for that. Come on, high five. Yeah.
So do they go with the Corki again is going to be the question, or are they going to switch it up to Ezreal, a pick that QG usually on Pekko, but Uzi's played it as well with his team, but it has been a major, major factor for Chao Gu this summer season.
And in many ways,
spring season.
In many ways, the best AD carry to deal with a Zed, because you go Iceborne Gauntlet, you get some natural armor there, and also you can very easily get QSS as your third item when you're fully stacked tier anyway. So you are still very strong on just those two items, and then the Zed can't really kill you. It's a lot of physical damage on the side of Fnatic. And I mean, last game, for some reason, the items from QG are a little bit weird. We had Hexstring of Fiora into like Quinn and Jhin and everything as second items of Black Cleaver against the Nautilus. And also Uzi went Last Whisper on Corki with a 70% magic damage. So if they can just itemize properly, late game, they will have a lot of answers to what Fnatic has built.
Deficio, will they be able to beat Fnatic and advance as the second seed from Group B? It is your final time to make a prediction.
Don't because be I'm from Europe, Fnatic takes it.
You voted with Mythy. You've both said Fnatic will advance. Monte Cristo, Fnatic or Chao Gu Reapers?
I'm actually going to go with Fnatic here just because Spirit was so exceptional on that Lee Sin in the last game. He's on fire right now, and Reckless has been so good on Jhin, and I just don't think it's something that QG really knows how to play against.
Gentlemen, your votes have been locked. They cannot be changed. We're going to head over to the Gassy TriCast, led by D-Man.
Thank you very much. I'm joined by the bitches once again, and we are ready to get this underway. Fnatic have just won the Counter-Strike. The question is, can they make the semifinals?
Can you just say Mitch, please?
Mitch, please.
Yeah. No, not like that. Can we swap? Is Joe in the building? Joe Miller somewhere?
Joe, Joe Miller,
can we get
where
the actually
you,
good caster back from in the days?
Oh my. We're off to a flying start, Lee. But at least.
I'm just going to leave it there.
At least we have a big game on hands as well. Now, you talked about the pick here as well for QG. You said you liked it despite us seeing Rek'Sai first time.
I like Rek'Sai
today.
Actually, Sin. I think QG play well with Rek'Sai overall. It's double tank, triple carry, 1-3 on split push. And that's what they're playing for, that trophy right there. Pretty. I never had one of them trophies. Did you? D-Man?
You got close, though, on the champions.
We don't talk about that.
The champions, man. I was so gutted. I mean, obviously, you were pretty happy, obviously. You were having a really good game as well.
Yeah.
Until
we won that best of three.
Deep down in your heart.
Uh-huh. Then it turned into a best of five, and then we were a bit unlucky.
Yeah. It was a Zubu Frost, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Back in the days. Reminisce to the good old
so
days.
So close, but yet so far. But still, you came closer than Deficio, so it's all right. So, what do we think of this one? What do we think? What are you going with? Where's your gut feeling?
A bit hungry, actually. No, I think QG have a... I don't know, I like them on stuff like Alistar, Rek'Sai and teamfights because it really enables like their usual teamfighting, but Uzi has been a bit sloppy so far, so we'll need to see an impeccable performance from him to really, really win these teamfights because Gamsu has been performing so well for Fnatic. If they can keep him down in the top lane and Uzi plays a little better than last game, I think UG have actually a good shot at winning this game because like Deficio pointed out at the analyst desk, the late game build paths are so crystal clear here for QG. They have their win conditions really spelled out for them. The late game split push with Fiora, building a lot of armor, the Zed will eventually be useless. If Spirit gets tracked down at the flanks, then obviously he can't go for the good kicks.
So is there a defined window for Fnatic where they need to close this out?
I mean, yeah, Fnatic will need to snowball, but there's one way to do it. It's with the crowd behind you.
Yeah. Can the crowd's energy get them going? The Chao Gu fans just on the edge as well. I can see Pico in my eye line. Obviously not played so far. Sat outside with Uzi discussing the games. Obviously figuring out what their plan was coming into this one. Aggression from Reckless. There's a good play from Clyde. Managing to get some more damage down. That will possibly prevent a decent start for Chao Gu, but it will be standard lanes.
It's a rough lane.
Very standard lanes.
So this is good for QG for the top laner. Obviously, V wants to farm as much as he can. Rek'Sai starts on the top side, though. Look where Spirit is starting. So he got a leash. So Spirit is actually going to do the same thing this game. Start bottom side, path towards the top side to help Gamzu out. So maybe we see a triple camp rotate to the top side here. Kind of surprising that
why
didn't get pushed in the bot lane.
Why go standard lanes after an absolute disaster of a start last time around? Why would Fnatic not try and force this?
I mean, maybe to fail predict. You never know, obviously. It's always a gamble. But Fnatic do want this 2v2 in the bot lane. Thresh, Jhin should be able to beat Alistar Ezreal. Kind of surprising that the push goes to QG here, even with that Alistar starting heal. Very surprising, actually. Should actually never happen, I feel.
And so surprisingly placid beginning.
Oh, this is why though. Cheesy Spirit level 2 gank. But to flash from more.
Cheese hasn't matured enough yet. Leave it for a little bit. It's a surprisingly placid start to the game apart from that one.
Apart from level 2 gank.
Well, an attempted level 2 gank. It was presence.
Yeah. Ooh. Now Rek'Sai, the cost of this play though is that the map is divided instead of by the river top and down, it's now left and right, and Swift, he is in the backside of Gamzu. Gamzu can no longer push up, so he's really scared of those ganks, and Rek'Sai can path over top lane over multiple walls with those tunnels, so Gamzu, yeah, trying to find out where is the jungler. Is he in here? And that's that's a really smart ward. He knows the tunnel is there, he knows Blue's gone, and he knows Grump isn't being taken, so Swift will likely just path towards the Grump and reveal himself here.
And he gives Spirit, obviously, the freedom to path around as well. Swift will clear out that ward, but they know then the wolves are gone, they know the exact path in. Gives a little freedom to everyone. Nice little trade there for Biven, getting some damage down Doinbi.
Swift really smart, doesn't then go for the Grump, because he knows I might get spotted here. Yeah. Doinbi losing the trades here early, though. Zed counter pick, Client Spirit join up. Ooh. This is good. Challenge the wave clear here. Zone off Doinbi, get Feven ahead. Look at Swift on the side, though. That's a bold prediction.
And now Swift is going to come in to teleport onto that tower as well. Client taking so much damage from the tower. Bit of shield from Safeguard will help, but V is doggedly chasing him down. He's slowed up. Surely the Prey Seeker and a little bit more damage across the map. There's First Blood going over towards V. QG picking that one up. Client, so overzealous.
I mean, he's just seeing it, you know. Kai with the God Mad Life predict wins the game for Fnatic, you know, Reddit all slash one. But then, yeah, you need Doinbi to kind of go for the W there to dodge that. He didn't
you
go for
see
it.
Completely missed the hook. The conflicted sort of teammates there for Biven and Spirit. Like, I want to block the damage, but
you can't. Like,
at one point,
there's
just no way of doing
it. He's in too deep. He just went for a play that had a big opportunity, like, cost a failure. If you go for that play, then.
Oh, nice. This is going to get answered. V's in trouble. He's going down. Gamzu will pick up the kill. And well, okay. You get our support. We'll get your top laner. And the top laner definitely going to be much better because that's going to give Gamzu a fair amount of freedom in that top lane to get some free experience, the gold earned. And of course, down this bottom lane. We did say it was going to be a rough lane to start with, but Rek'Sai has been given a lot of freedom down here.
Yeah, it was a rough lane for Ezreal Alistar to start with, but the CS, even though the push pressure is on QG, the CS seems bang on even though, but I think Rek'Sai and Klai should be able to push this advantage a little more forward. We have to remember that Klai was roaming to the mid lane, so that cost a lot of pressure here in the bottom lane and obviously let QG push in 2v2. Now we need Feven to kind of snowball off that pressure. But whatever, Doinbi lost the creeps on the tower. He got an experience on that assist. So things surprisingly even. Key matchup to still watch is the top lane, though. That is the most important matchup of this game. Gamzu versus V.
We've seen it go both ways already this game, and we've seen how that's actually impacted the rest of the map. But now for Biven, gonna get jumped on. Doinbi does land the chain to the rest of QG there to follow up. It's a teleport coming in. Will this be in time? They've backed off for Biven, and now Gamzu is there. Dredgeline connects on towards Doinbi, and Spirit is also there. He's gonna lay this damage down. Doinbi gonna struggle to get away. He has to distort. Spirit's still there. It's gonna be a depth charge, and that'll secure the kill, no doubt about it. More now. He's surrounded, caught between a rock and a very angry Lee Sin, who will push forward, but Biven gets that kill, and this is a good, good little start from Fnatic here.
That is just about all they could hope for. I mean, that Maw was looking to set that one up, but again, for Biven, just doing the perfect bait. He's setting it up beautifully. I was worried. I thought the exhaust, the more obviously he was coming in, I was like, okay, here we go. He's going to get caught out. He got the pulverize, got the head, but it was all so nice. But the hook definitely turned it around from Gamsu.
Yeah, this play being set up here. I wonder if Fnatic knew this was coming or is this purely reactive. Instant TP, something we faulted from Gamsu before, that he was late. Remember, Fnatic has teleport advantage from that previous play. Spirit joins in again. Spirit actually reacting to so many plays here compared to the first game. He's definitely been on fire the last two games. Every time, at the right place. But QG going for this play, being down the teleport, is a little bit overzealous though. Because V turned around a similar gank just earlier in the mid lane. They have to realize that Gamsu still had teleport available to thwart that play.
So what does this now mean for Fnatic Cripple after managing to turn that around?
I mean, they just pulled themselves 1k ahead in a very skirmish heavy composition. Febron is now ahead. Look, level 6 versus level 5. He has the zone. Ignite's coming up, or is up already. He now has the lead. And Doenbi's under pressure. That means Fnatic can always push up mid. Push prio in mid means Zed can roam. And a roaming Zed spells danger.
Speaking of roaming danger, look down the bottom. Four members of Fnatic all piling down the river. Uzi and Moore need to respect the power and presence that Fnatic have at the moment. Spirit will just step away, looking to try and get something, but they're not falling for it. So Forbidden will return to Riven. It's actually working out so well for him against Doenbi. Don't worry, the thing with LeBlanc is you need to get them kills. You need to get those early ganks, get the little bit of items in there to get yourself rolling. But yeah. Forbidden has played this very well.
Definitely into such a crucial matchup as Zed LeBlanc. And look at Gams though, he's barely in his lane. Push up, roam, push up, find the jungler in his jungle, or the enemy jungler in his jungle. Push up again, I'll put some pressure on the Rift Herald. I think he just sold out himself down, go back to the top lane, teleport in. So he's just putting so much more pressure onto QG, something from Gamsu that we said in European LCS, that he played on an island, didn't have much impact, did some really dumb stuff, you know, overextending, and he's really stepped up together with Spirit in some of these games today.
So is this Fnatic basically adjusting and figuring out? I mean, we talked about how they've obviously had the week's prep time to come into here. They know they're into an international competition. It's not the tried and tested European teams they're up against. Have they basically figured out what Fnatic needs to do now? I mean, it's very early signs, clearly, but Gamsu and Spirit coming into this team, obviously it was always going to be like a how do we gel them? How do we make best use of them?
I mean, they're just making good decisions. He's just getting the help when he needs to. Like, when you top, sometimes you need to just help your top lane. You can't just tunnel on the one stout with certain people ahead. Fnatic now looking to forward their advantage by an invade here, hoping to catch Doenbi when he goes for the blue buff.
Oh, nice.
By making some plays, and that's a play as well. Doenbi
trying to get
away, but again, the distort's not going to be enough. Swift still wants his blue buff, so going to try and take that away as he does put some damage back towards Spirit.
And that's what you need to do. You read the game. What is my opponent going to do next? Well, he's playing LeBlanc and he's behind. What does he want? A blue buff. They knew the blue buff was being done, but instead of going for the steal, the 50-50, they put a pink ward in the brush. They hide Kai with a solid hook from Fog of War, and instant. Everything used, no hesitation, no half measures, just kill Doenbi, and now Febben is spiraling out of control in a very tippy matchup. Tipping forward right now to the side of Fnatic.
Everything was used by Doenbi there as well. All his summoners were down. Swift, oof, just getting out of that one. The hooks from Klai have been a little awry. Spirit, though, is on point. Swift, very aggressive stuff there. Knew he had the tower support and Doenbi coming in to try and pick up, collect something, but he's falling behind. The ping ward being cleared out by Moore, though. So Chao Gu, not one to shy away from a fight, still looking to try and create something off the back of this.
Yeah,
and Swift,
want.
He wants to try and get a steal away here. He's already got the blue himself, remember, over in his half of the jungle. And Doenbi looking to try and get one, but it's too late. Forbidden has it already. Back to the mid lane. But there's three members stacked around there. Are they going to try and pressure? No.
Crucial there as well to deny that from Doenbi, like you pointed out. Forbidden can make use of it, of course, in the same way that Swift can.
No Deficio, no Blue Steel.
Oh, yes.
Still tries to pull it off, bless him.
I mean, the cheekbones.
Well, I mean, sadly, the second film was a flop, so it's just not really there anymore, is it?
Wouldn't know. Never watched it.
Zoolander, guys, at home. Free advertising there for you guys. They need all they can get right now. It's just a piece of trash as a film. But anyway, moving on.
I quite like it. That was the basis for all myself.
You quite liked it.
From age 16 up.
Well, the first one was fine. The second one's bad. Anyway, moving along. Film critiquing aside, Swift, are they going to let him go? Yes, they are. Gamsu, you never really know where that hook's going to fly out. It's been left, right, and center so far. Doenbi trying to bait something in, but Swift will continue to push. So Fnatic, they've got themselves a 4-1 lead. Ooh, little adventurous, nice little play there, little combo.
Yeah, combo into poke, disengage. That's the way QG want to play. After that combo goes down, obviously you have no more potential to win a fight. Uzi is playing a tier Sheen build, so again, get that Sheen proc off, back off, and right now you want to just disincentivize Fnatic from going for the all-in, because if Kali goes for the all-in right now, he will just die. Because I see two nodding casters next to me.
We were just blown away by your use of big words.
Vocabulary, I really do.
He pulls the big words out. I don't.
I heard Monty say discombobulated earlier today. It's one of my favorite words.
Oh, well, Curtain Call, we're here for Reckless trying to clear the wave, but he might be in trouble. Swift is trying to capture them. It's a summoner heal by Clyde to try and get some distance
Gamsu.
It's the bait. It looks like the hook comes in for Swift and Reckless out towards the back, but here's Gamsu. He's got them all locked up with the death charge for two, and Uzi trying to duel that with Reckless, but he doesn't have the damage, and Gamsu gets one as well. We can see the Toynbee getting away with more of a fall for Vivid. Right place, right time, take a bow.
Yeah, and if you look at the minimap, though, you see Spirit and topside. Kick is down. Guess what? Is also down. It's a teleport from V. QG were completely expecting him to come in. That's why they did the pathing the way they did. And then it got canceled by a good kick there from Spirit. Hopefully we can get that on a replay later, because that turned the fight even more. Then Fevin obviously has the lead. He comes down. Dolanby can't join the fight. And this might be the nail in the coffin here. Over 3,000 gold lead for Fnatic.
13 minutes in. This is a massive, massive advantage. There we go. This is the start of it. Reckless already used the ulti, I mean, that wasn't available, but this is the danger. You could see they were setting up for
more. You can't do this. You have to go for the Q flash on the knock-up there. You don't have time to go for WQ.
Oh.
Spirit kicks him out, walks away, and this is just greedy by QG. While they usually understand fights so well, you can't leave a window of opportunity for Clyde to flash back, because he will flash out, hook you, your combo will be down, you will be absolutely and utterly useless. And for me, that is the biggest mistake in that fight from QG. If you're going for that dive, don't leave any flash windows open. It's the same when we watched Xmithie Gragas. You go E, Q, R, no, ER. Don't let anybody flash out. Just use your flash offensively.
Chaogu are getting flashbacks at the moment. Flashbacks of the second game, and this is going disastrously wrong for them. Remember, Royal Never Give Up will be the opponents for the winner of this matchup in the semi-final. Could Fnatic have a double Chinese setup and almost do basically like Gambit did many years ago when they took down the two Korean teams completely unexpected. Fnatic coming into this one, a very much an average European team right now, which is very, I think, honest to say for them. They never have had good results throughout this entire season against any good teams. No. And here they are against Chaogu right now, 7-1 up in a best of three series.
Yeah, they had that one game against H2K, where it was Odoamne kind of handing it to them with that teleport. They've had some comebacks. Was it the G2 game, I think? But again, that was a massive throw by G2. More right now. Last to block the Lantern. Doesn't get his booty around it. Clyde gets
This is what Chaogu do. We're like, what do? We're behind. We fight.
You force.
Yeah.
You have to force
fights.
I think more wishes he was a big booty Mitch right now to get on that one. Right. No good. Gamsu in the top side. Again, he's going to push. Can I have a high five? Give me some of that. Got to get involved, boys.
Well, I mean, if Trevor's doing high fives with DeFizio, it's only fair that we get involved, man. We've got to get some of that action going on here. But
look at this. Like action here for you?
Look at what's going on here.
I thought he could handle the Mitches.
Yeah. Doin B. I'll just stick to the game, guys. Stick to the game.
Yeah, sure.
Doin B taking the Wolves away from Swift. That's just how far behind they are right now. In terms of CS, in terms of kills, it's starting to become a disaster for them. They're just doing anything they can. And look at Spirit. Spirit's like, where do you think you're going? The bouncer on here, stopping them coming through. Uzi's trying to get his way through. For Bivon. Uh-oh, he's got buddies. He's got support. Spirit, though, in trouble. He will get talked down. And well, the little Ikes are trying to knock in the front door now. For Bivon, just gets around the side there. Reckless is going to join him. Where's Gamsu? Here he comes, round the side. Locks in towards them. There's another hook. Uzi gets caught out. This is all going so, so well for Fnatic. Doinby's going to get himself dropped down. That Ignite running through on the Mimic. More not going to get away from this one. It's going to be a 2-for-1. Not the best of trades. Could have come out much better for Fnatic. They really want to gift this one across to Reckless. Come on, eventually.
Yeah, no. Fevin's going to take it down. More was out of mana that he queued up, walked up, and was going to knock you in the tower. If only I had mana available. So a little bit miscalculation here. It does open up V right now. He uses teleport, I think top lane, to finish the tower, because it's just gone on cooldown, which means another TP advantage here from Fnatic.
Okay, so it wasn't a massive fight win from Natty. They only got two kills, but now what's the opening from this? Where do they transition? Is it just Dragon? Can they go elsewhere? Do they have time?
I mean, they can do whatever they want, because yes, it's just one kill extra, but it's also the teleport. Actually, I lied. It was still on cooldown. Okay, I'm blind. Never mind, boys. Take it away. My opponent is mute.
That's okay, man. I wasn't listening.
Probably too hard for you to understand anyways.
Yeah, that was a little deep.
Team fight, push, CS. D-man.
It was a little deep.
It's a little more complex than people just shooting at each other, you know?
Maybe. Are you saying CS is simple? Because we can start this debate if you really want to.
Said nothing of the sort.
Oh, I'm pretty sure you just did.
Why do you need to stand between you two?
It's okay. We're sharing the hotel with all the CS players. We'll discuss this later.
I'm sure it'd be fun, Lee. Anyway.
Actually, no, they're all going to be a party, aren't they? Nobody will be there. It'd be brilliant. But anyway, Rift Herald going down.
It's Rift Herald being worked on here. And Fnatic, 9-2 in terms of kills. We haven't really had a look at the scoreboard much recently. Of course, you can all see it at home. 5K for them here. But again, that Zed, you said that later on he might fall over. He's 3-0-2 right now, though.
No, he ain't falling over. The only one that might fall over here is Gamsu, though. Knock, knock. Who's there?
Oh, Uzi's going to try and get himself the kill here, but Gamsu is one big tanky beast. He's going to keep running them in. He can turn a hook around here. Swift is going to get knocked away, gets himself the shield down. This is going to tank it around, but what damage is going to cause? It's going to be the top lane where the problem's coming from. And Fnatic, well, they're going to get themselves a tower at the bare minimum. It's a tier two. They can keep pushing. Changu have to back away. They're not even going to get a tower from this, are they?
Okay, Gamsu out, Gatsu back in here. Uzi stuck in the bottom lane, Fnatic 4 in the top lane.
Gamsu, a player who didn't get much involvement. We said he was left on an island, not much gold even channeling in his direction. I mean, Fnatic aren't so much involving him. He is involving himself.
Yup, he's like, come at me, just get me some help. Launch me forward, and then a big booty Nautilus. Big shield, big anchor, everything's big there. Yeah, just completely rexed. This is so disappointing for QG. You think you finally have an opening? It's like, guys, we got the CC combo into knockup. And you're like, where's the damage? Anybody brought some damage to the party? Nope.
Going once.
No. Nope.
Twice.
They get the tower, though. QG, they trade one for one on towers. 4,000 gold gap. But if Fnatic actually choose to start team fighting right now with Gamps in the front line, you have to wonder where the damage is going to come from QG.
I mean, Forbidden, we see already Azonya's Hourglass here for Doin B. Forbidden, it almost seems like he's forced Doin B into a bit of an average build for LeBlanc.
Yeah. LeBlanc with Zonya snowballing is okay into his Zed, but Zonya's from behind just becomes such a poor build because it doesn't even keep you alive. Forbidden just has enough damage to burn through it anyways, and you just have no impact. Doin B, there's not a single target on Fnatic that Doin B can find that he can one-shot. Maybe Reckless.
Rift Herald buff being used there by Forbidden, you just tore down the bottom lane, but not going to follow it through. Doesn't fancy it just yet. So V will get himself a bit of farm while this is all happening. You see the old 1-3-1 split coming out. Gamsu working his magic in that top lane. Teleport available, of course, should he require it. Rectus pretty much had a free and easy game so far, him and Clyde. Clyde been making the plays, then 5 assists on him.
And how dangerous is that when we've seen Reckless's Jhin get towards the later period and just start to absolutely decimate?
Yeah. I mean, anything's dangerous at this time for Fnatic. Like, Reckless, he's shown that he can really snipe people with that ultimate later on. And QG, the thing is, if people can dodge, like, multiple directions, it's really hard to hit them on skill shots. But QG will be only running in one direction, and that's away from Fnatic. That will make it a lot easier for Reckless to snipe down.
Okay, so pings on V in the top. So they say, thank you very much. Okay, you're going to have one there. Let's see if we can get a bit of a flank maneuver going on. Uzi's going to try and use that True Shot Barrage to clear the wave. Not going to quite work out. No picks coming from Fnatic, though. You can see Gansu just dancing and weaving off the side there. Meanwhile, Forbidden returns back to the bottom lane. At the moment, they're just juggling back and forward between the lanes, and Changu just having to react to every time.
Yeah, 4-1 split push, 1-3-1 split push maybe. Gamsu's teleport available. That's what Fnatic want to do. Isolate the Zed, because after all, he is an assassin, and they work best in 1v1 environments, especially if he enters team fights. He has to go through an exhaust, maybe some crowd control effects. Obviously, can't be used to his maximum utility. At this point, he can team fight because he's super fed. But Zed's main forte is still obviously that 1-for-1 split push.
Any concerns about Fnatic's ability to close this one out?
I mean, I would say no, but then I haven't always been right this tournament. I think they have the knowledge to close out this game. They will need to keep split pushing. It is hard though in this meta to open up tier 2s if the enemy teams know what they're doing. So
I think Fnatic will need a good Baron play. And that is something actually they have struggled with in the European LCS. They've kind of skipped some steps. If you want to secure the Baron, it's push in, deep vision, push in again, then move to the Baron. Fnatic always managed to mess up at least one of these steps.
Well, the Muramana has converted for Uzi, so he's going to be much more of a threat now, along with those Iceborne Gauntlet. The Ezreal should try and set up something for Doyen B. So that's what Chaogun and Mirami perhaps looking towards. You can see that immediately how much more aggressive they are. They've all shoved down the lanes. They're all trying to clear the path a little bit, trying to get themselves the tiniest bit of vision. Of course, you can see Baron is up, but of course, the Dragon in 30 seconds is what they're going to maybe try and peek towards.
Yeah, Chaogun's kind of way back into the game is to fight Fnatic on an objective when Fnatic does, like, the objective at the start, peel off the fight, Chaogun kite with that blue Ezreal, and then somehow V enters the fight either late or untouched, and then he has the continuous damage to really do damage at the end of the fight, because he's the only really good damage output outside of the Ezreal, who's kind of wants to kite. But it's very conditional. There's a lot of things have to go right now, which means Alistar from Moore and Rek'Sai from Swift have to really soak up a lot of damage, and then Fnatic need to play into QG's hands. But QG have won a lot of teamfights from considerably larger gold deficits.
Absolutely.
So technically possible.
Wouldn't really be anything new for them now. I mean, maybe we'll forget that. I guess it's, we've seen these games so far, but that Dragon is live and fly. Beckons for Reckless to come and join him. His Spirit's already got that one started off here, and it'll be their second. Not the only team with Dragon so far in this one. And I mean, the anticipation for when it starts to get those Baron dances is definitely palpable.
Yeah, it has to be the Baron dance. Two Dragons out in 23 minutes doesn't mean they're is a five dragon threat, really, before we enter the super late game where Fiora and Ezreal is enough as a two damage component. The long kind of falls off. Don't want to be struggling to find damage, though. That Hourglass build.
Maul's going to have to use his ultimate here, and that's not even going to save him, I don't feel. Spirit going to take a lot of damage, though. He gets out just about alive! How the hell did he survive that one? Uzi, that's going to be a Forbidden getting the pop on him. Maul goes down. This is exactly what Fnatic were looking for. Chaogun, they just wanted a little peek through the bushes, but Fnatic slapped them in the face.
Yeah, Uzi couldn't escape that death charge. At the same frame he hits, he gets a ninja on his tail too. Febben, so much damage. Ignite's still available still, and this is, yeah, this is big. It looked okay. It looked like a trade jungler for support, but Spirit not going down there is the deciding factor in this fight.
They're going to need him for this one as well. As Swift also lurking close by, still potential for a Baron steal as Doyen B just throws in the old leash and tries to get a feel for things here. But Fnatic are adamant. They're going to stick on this one. Obviously, Uzi still going to be coming back in here. It's going to get a little bit close here. Doyen B is going to get jumped on though as well. He's super low already. The passive pop. Swift is going to be locked up there in position. It's curtain call now. Doyen B just gets out of trouble. He stayed alive for so long, but that Baron still doing damage to Fnatic.
Oh, this Swift, is risky that's a steal. Stuff. It's so low. He's going in for the steal.
Fnatic are all just so low. They tried to tank it for so long. They kick Swift out of the pit. They do finally lock it down. Fnatic get in there. There we go. Reckless lands the damage. Moore gonna get taken down eventually. There it is. Reckless finishes him off. Gets himself the triple, but oh my word. Was that close for Fnatic?
Yeah, QG completely surprised by the fact that the fight went so long that Spirit's kick was back available. This is how it all began. Moore has to ultimate at the time. Look at Spirit, how low he goes. How low can he go? Well, that low is how low he can go. Uzi, pop, 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 boom, goes the depth shard. He goes down, Febben takes him down, and then the fight is lost, and now they have to go to the Baron, but then, yeah, Lucian doesn't have kick. Let's wait, Rek'Sai can steal. But Fnatic stall out so long that eventually, and it's a long time though, Spirit's kick comes back available.
Well, 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 high fives for all here. I mean, but this is now where that second fight sort of started as well. Doyen B stayed alive for quite a while after.
Yeah, everybody's fighting each other and the Baron at the same time. Look at it. Doyen B takes the hook. The only one that has to survive is Swift because he can smite steal. And he's doing a really good job. Fnatic keep the Baron from going low enough though. They say, okay, wait, 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 hold, hold, hold. Don't let him 50-50 it. Don't let him steal it. So they back off, they back off. Swift, Spirit is still waiting for his kick and here it comes. Once he kicks him out, that's when Fnatic turned to the Baron. Swift is a little bit late on the flash. He doesn't expect it to burn. Fnatic, really good communication here. This is like frame perfect. This is so hard to pull off. Because if Swift flashes in like a fraction of a second later or earlier and he steals the Baron, Fnatic tilts for life.
That was the lined up double kill as well from Reckless with the skill shot there. Very nice from him. Worked out well for them. 15-5 the kills. Massive advantage for Fnatic here in game number 3. Who would have thunk it? After watching them play this morning, they've definitely developed throughout
the day. I thought I was ready for an early bureau clock here. Fnatic get 0-2, I get to go home to the hotel, turn it all around. Worth it though for me, some really good games.
High risk Baron for Fnatic, but we knew it would be a climactic fight around there. Now they're gonna press forward here, and this is QG's chance. And sometimes their solution, the only solution they have in their heads is to fight. Fnatic have to be careful and maybe just try and sharp these waves in. Let's QG catch them unaware. This might be it for Vivin chained up. There's a lantern there.
Yeah, only one chain. Definitely did not excite Fevivin there. Almost no damage.
Dorian B just trying to find anything, do anything, just cause any sort of disruption, but Fnatic happy just is back away. No Baron buff, of course, four for Vivin. He'll get taken down in that initial exchange, but now he can go. He's the man that needs to be split pushing. We saw Gamsu up there a moment ago. Finally, it is going to be Forbidden that's going to start doing the little split push dance. Doesn't have the Baron buff though, so he's not going to have that added bonus like we got down the bottom.
Yeah, but it's just a threat of the dive. That's enough. Just needs to divide and conquer kind of for Fnatic. Split QG up. If you have a team that's really good at coming back by team fighting, well, perhaps best not to let them team fight. That's Fnatic's approach here. Obviously,
he
said isolated.
Giving up on the split push. Just decided to back away and try and draw some attention away, it looks like.
I think it's okay to back off because it wasn't working. They weren't busting the defense. And you would only just feed farming over and over. Why not take away more gold on the map? Get your camps after you clear their camps. Shop, get more items. QG, once they path into the map again, they can get picked off. You can't pick people in their base. So hard to accomplish that. And at least it throws. So Fnatic, proceeding with understandable caution.
So that gold lead is now blown out to 10k, and of course Fnatic stacking those turrets up one after another, and you have to think that they're going to be sort of grouping up again for another one. Now Crepo, are we expecting to see that sort of 4-1 split push here? I mean, it's only really Gamsu. Do they work for Bivinian on one side? Do they try a new spirit?
Yeah, they go 4-1, 1-3-1. They keep altering it until QG cracks somewhere. Mm. And if not, they will likely go for another Baron. So we could see Dragon obviously being contested here. QG is going to let that drop, third Dragon. Fnatic will then keep poking away. You know, if QG get caught, great. End the game.
Oh, Spirit actually going to go try and dive deep on Uzi there, but will get caught. More slamming his fists into the ground and protecting his support. Yeah, but then of course that does mean Dragon up in 12 seconds. That's going to be the objective. That's where they back away. Just trying to get a bit of a moment of opportunity on Uzi there.
QG just starving for farm. They can't even. The Raptors is too deep territory. That's enemy territory. Your own wolves is at this point is enemy territory. So all you can do is wait for waves to hit your towers. So Fnatic actually pushing in the waves is helping. So they're just gonna get the Dragon here, get complete vision control, and avoid being picked off.
So what does that mean then, Crepo, about QG's option? Is it just their favorite plan B to fight? Is that really the only way?
It's wait for a mistake. That's all they can do right now. But then they have to really use one of their strengths, which is decisively pulling the trigger with very little information, because they won't have much vision. Because all their vision is going to these blue trinkets, which they'll put in a rotation once the Baron spawns, and hopefully avoid dying.
And that's the key. Everybody saw the TSM game yesterday morning. Everybody paid attention to that. Chaogu are known for fighting from behind. They guarantee if this game goes longer and longer and longer, the more items they get, they're going to be looking for that fight. And obviously the gold advantage that is currently there, 11,000, gigantic number right now, but Fnatic still yet to try and break through. Here's Swift getting caught out though, that could be a starter. Spirit joins the party, the Korean double wombo combo on them, and Reckless comes around the side, not going to allow him to get away. Doin B getting caught out, he's going to be the next focus. The Zonya's only going to save him for so long, but it doesn't matter. The rest of the team are now the target, and that's going to be a deep, deep dive from Spirit as they pile in, but Bivin goes deep. Here's the ulti from Reckless. Oh, it's blocked out by Doinb's Mimic.
Yep, and then Uzi takes a couple of shots. Doesn't matter. They had a tower, though, to take a little bit of advantage of that play. Everybody's in base right now, so Fnatic to go back. They get one pick. Yeah, sloppy fight overall. Spirit again with a good opening, though. This guy, complete different player all of a sudden.
On Lee Sin. Have,
yeah, multiple shades here.
Is this something that's been banned against him heavily in EULCS?
I don't think so.
Let's just quantify it. He's a Korean jungler, so therefore Lee Sin is obviously in his package.
It's more than Nidalee that is consistent.
Yeah, Nidalee has been heavily consistently banned, but Spirit overall just hasn't been on some of these picks just generating defiance, and the way he's doing this game, it's actually just such a different performance here. He's found so many openings in this game.
It's because also in a lot, in a big way, Fnatic are ready to follow up on what Spirit's doing. Yesterday in the interview, Reckless said, traveling with my team really gives us a good sense of synergy. Just the everyday, you know, how you going, sharing a room, just Which chatting is, about everything.
It's crazy when you think of every other esport out there, but obviously that is just the structure of LCS. I mean, while they all sit and live in the same house, you know, it's crazy that just a simple little thing like traveling, which obviously they're getting worlds.
I'm gonna assume that this is not due to the merit of traveling.
I know, well, it's
all right, guys, let's go to Barcelona. Suddenly, my jungler can not
It's the merit of having problems and having to get through it as a team. And
that's what Fnatic had, though. Plenty of problems.
Point is, communication seems to be better. They're following up on Spirit, who likes to go in quite deep. You can see he used a kick there. Didn't quite yield the opportunity for Fnatic, but they're going to press forward anyway.
Yeah. So if we want to improve our... Hang on. Never mind.
Hang on. Here goes Chao Gu, but the question is, Uzi's going to get caught out. Manages to QSS him, but Vivid dives on towards him. Doi B's going to get picked up the side. Sonya's Hourglass comes out, but how long will that keep him alive? Not very long. Vivid gets himself a double. Make it a triple. Vega's going to be the next focus. Little shot comes in. There's the Quadra, and they're just going to dial it back. And Fnatic in full control here as they get themselves the ace and most likely the game.
They're going to think about just, oh, we forgot to get that inhibitor. Now they've got to press forward. Fnatic, massive fight for Biffin. There were concerns about him towards the late game, but he just never stopped getting massive. And Fnatic now pushed on towards it. They've done it. They've evolved themselves throughout the whole day, just like we talked about TSM. And they've made it into tomorrow. Chao Gu have been upset. Fnatic, we'll see you tomorrow.
Semi-finals for Fnatic up against Royal Never Give Up. They've defeated one Chinese team. Can they do it again? It's a big ask, no doubt about it, but they're going to be making it into the Spodek tomorrow and potentially reaching that really big best of five final. Of course, SKT versus TSM is the other mouth-watering match.
There was maybe like 1,000 people here in the crowd, I think.
2,000 people here into the Spodek. You're up to 11,000.
Yeah, and there was a lot.
Ramp up that.
There was
volume.
A lot of Fnatic shirts here already. Tomorrow, that's going to be absolutely massive. Home field advantage here for Fnatic, and they seem to really thrive off the energy and positive energy, momentum, and flow, etc. So that's going to be very interesting to see that at the Spodek tomorrow.
What a relief for them. After game one of the previous series, Klai, he ran away from the desk. He put his head against the wall. He was so frustrated and upset with himself. But in the last couple of games, something's clicked. For Fnatic, things are now running as they want them to. And that's going to make tomorrow that much more exciting, Lee.
What a fantastic match it has been. Let's get over to the analyst desk to take us through with final thoughts.
How on earth do you follow a best of three like that? It is difficult to really pinpoint a few things, but for Fnatic, the Costa said it best. The pieces came together. Spirit found a champion that he really could impact the game with. Reckless was a real threat on Jhin. Klai was finding hooks that were correct and at the right time. It just feels like everybody just stepped it up a notch and found another gear.
So many good comfort picks for Fnatic in this last pick and ban phase again, and that makes it easier. You already have the confidence from winning that last game. When Spirit played Lee Sin last week in the ULCS, he also went completely nuts. Deserved MVP for sure from that game. This pick is the pick he needs to play, or at least something like it, because he's so good at setting up these skirmishes.
Yeah, it's always been like that ever since, you know, starting out on Samsung Blue, taking over the jungle role there, and really at the inception of his career. And now we see again him really making these plays on the Lee Sin. And this is what we wanted from him. Like, this is what I wanted. I look at some of these other drafts that Fnatic has been playing about, and I hate to harp on it, but that draft against H2K where they take mid Gangplank and bottom Ezreal, they've really made that shift. They go into some lane dominance. They pick very heavily for that Jhin, looking for the lane dominance over the course of today, and then they start to play more aggressive champions on Fevvin. It opens up Spirit to make the plays, and that's why you hired Spirit in the first place.
We have a replay to demonstrate exactly this point. Let's pull it up. I don't want to do too many replays, but this is really quite an exciting one where Fevvin demonstrates, roll the clip out. He manages to shut down Uzi on the Zed, of course, and then the quite dramatic Baron play. Deficio, what do you make of this? Again, it's Fnatic, it's aggressive, and it's them pushing into QG territory.
Yeah, again, you have a 1-3-1 and you've gotten ahead, and Uzi has no QSS yet, so this is a super good play from Fnatic. I actually think Uzi went last Whisper's third item instead of just rushing QSS. In my opinion, completely useless. Your job is not right now to take care of the Nautilus, it's to survive that Zed engage and then be able to kite backwards. Baron starts, obviously becomes a bit messy for Fnatic because there's a lot of split calls here. Half the team is probably calling to finish the Baron and try and kick away the Rek side. The other half is saying, oh, I'm hooking, you know, LeBlanc, let's go for it. Get baited by the Hourglass a little bit, and that was very in and out, tanking the Baron. Still fairly early on in the game. Spirit in the end, though, shows he has the control.
Yeah, just really actually quite awkward. Reckless, too, with the curtain call over the wall. It's just, you need to concentrate that DPS at that point in time or make some sort of commitment. Eventually, though, Spirit does commit and make the play on the re-engage of the Baron, and that makes all the difference.
I want to go back to yesterday and the intro to the entire show. The two Western teams where we talked about wrong pick and ban phases and not utilizing strong mechanical junglers was Team Solo Mid and Fnatic. Svensson and Spirit were the two junglers. We said for both teams, we want to see early game, we want to see Lee Sin picks, we want to see mid laners who can push early, who can set up picks with this jungler, because then you can utilize them. Both teams have adapted. Both teams are now in the semifinal, while CNG and Origin are out from the West.
Yeah, definitely are knocked out. And, you know, if Spirit was running the Place.tv extension, he could have recorded and shared all of his clips on social media. Spirit is also waiting on stage, where Shox is about to interview him.
Thank you, Trevor. Who else could I talk to first but Spirit? Congratulations, making it to the semifinal. What a day for you guys, starting off with that tough loss and then turning it all around throughout the day, coming together as a team. Just tell me first, from your perspective, how you've lived this crazy day with Team Fnatic.
Do you know why we lose first game?
No.
Because we want to play more and we want to practice more, and I wanna play in stage many games, you know.
Spirit, when you get your hands on Lee Sin and you play like that in Fnatic, I think we all want to watch that every day. Is that aggressive style what you think you should play like as much as possible?
When I play Lee Sin, my playstyle is super aggressive, because when I play Lee Sin, I have so much confidence, and I will beat them, I will smash them, I will kick them, yeah. So, yeah, so it's good for my team, I think, yeah.
I think these last games have proven that it's good. Can you signal maybe where throughout the day that you felt something within the team click and it all came together and you all seem to be on the same page, fighting on the same page, fighting very well together? Do you think that is because you've played so many games here today and you're making this trip together, playing in front of this crowd together? I might have made that a bit complicated.
Because we just focus more and we just trust each other. So we just think we never lose this game. We have to revenge versus QG. Yeah, so we just try hard for my life, yeah.
You probably have used a lot of energy today, a long day. Pun not intended, tomorrow you're up against RNG. You have to do it all again tomorrow to make it to the final. You will be playing on the big stage, the big crowd as well. Just tell me how you're going to bed tonight, what you're thinking about, and how you're going to get ready for that.
First, I have to keep my mind positive. We can beat RNG. Yeah, I think I can beat RNG. We can beat RNG. Yeah. So, but I worry Mata, Lupo, RNG is Korean, really, really strong. Yeah. So, if I play Lee Sin or any champion, and if I kill enemy, Lupo and Mata, I kick Lupo's mentor. Yeah. So. If I kick Lupo's meta, maybe we can win, yeah.
You say you can beat him? Yeah. Last question, are you already thinking about possibly SKT if everything falls right.
It's too hard.
Yeah. No.
But I try.
Yeah, I don't mean to put you in that position.
So before this interview, I had asked him, do you want to do this in English? And he said, no, I think I'll just do it in Korean. It might be more comfortable for me. So I came here and I said, if you have, you know, a question, you want to do it in English, I can help you out. Like training wheels, right? This guy has been fantastic in English. I think you should give
him a round of applause. Amazing. Cool. We can do interviews now every week back in the European LCS, you know, if you guys win. No, thank you. Thank you very much, Spirit. Fantastic interview, fantastic day from Fnatic. Guys, talk about it some more.
Exceptional.
Love to.
Absolutely exceptional. Love to. If Fnatic do not make a t-shirt that says, you know why we lose game one? Because I want to play on this stage more. You know, hashtag Spirit says. I think that's brilliant. And I mean, let's just round out the series.
Sure.
Fnatic really stepped up. They lost game one to QG. QG made a number of mistakes. They played with Uzi. They didn't play with Pekko, who's not their starting.
Mistake number one.
I mean, they're out of the tournament. And talk to me about some of the adaptations, some of the good from Fnatic as well as some of the bad from QG.
I felt like the adaptation from game two, game three, pick and ban-wise, wasn't there for QG. We talked about this Jhin pick. They clearly didn't really feel comfortable playing against, also blocked that Kalista pick. And when you don't ban the Jhin, Nautilus first pick comes in again, and there's never really a question if they're going to first pick Nautilus or Kalista. And that means Gamsu, again, gets one of his absolute main picks up in the top lane. And then we talked about that Rek'Sai pick. If you want to play a better matchup into Lee Sin, why not just take the Lee Sin?
That was my idea.
I mean, it felt like kind of disrespectful that some of these comfort picks that Fnatic had really shown up on Jhin and the Lee Sin were not picked away or banned away by QG. And I also feel like Doing B got kind of exposed in this series here. His champion pool, having to blind pick that LeBlanc to take it away from Fevrin, getting counter picked by Zed. And then that Victor last pick in the game before into Quinn, he did not have a great series, and this is one of the better mid laners in China.
He's played, again, those two picks, the overwhelming majority, I think all but four of the games so far they played. So I think 13 out of 17 in the LPL season have been on Victor or LeBlanc. And these have, he just didn't have much in the pool. At least he brought out the Lissandra here and actually did pretty well on that.
Yeah.
And hadn't played that at all in the spring season.
And what happened when Fnatic saw a pick he did well on? They banned it. They respected the fact that he actually performed super well on Lissandra. They took it away instead of just trying to run into the same wall again and again. It's going to hurt just as much the second time.
Well, some props to Fnatic. Let's take a look at the Group B bracket. Now that it is concluded and wrapped up, absolutely no surprises. SK Telecom, they crushed their two best of ones. They will be in the semifinal tomorrow against Team Solo Mid. And then a big surprise with Fnatic running the gauntlet in Fnatic style, taking series all the way. Monty, now that you see the bracket in its completion, what have we learned from today? We can have some takeaways from some of the other teams we haven't spoken about.
I think SK Telecom, the big surprise was Blank, especially on that Gragas game, was really quite good coming from the jungle position. And from a guy who really hadn't done anything noteworthy in Korea, of course, we're glossing over the LPL that he had actually last year, but in Korea, in his games with SK Telecom, he was really a non-factor. And then to come back and make such strong performances today was quite inspiring, I think.
Another jungler Spirit, we heard from him before, fantastic performance, obviously stepping up. Also, Klai, a guy we had some pretty rough words for coming into this, made a big mistake in the last game, and then he actually steps up and performs really well from there on and out, a young guy and doing well.
Yes.
What are you laughing
about? Incredibly good performance. Carmack has literally just climbed under the table because he's exceptionally happy with how the League of Legends tournament has played out today in the Expo Arena. Let's set up the matches that will be happening tomorrow in the Spodek here in Katowice, Poland. Bring up the bracket. We can see the playoffs and how they're going to play themselves out. He's tying my shoelaces together, people. What am I meant to do with this? TSM versus SK Telecom T1 in the top of the bracket. RNG against Fnatic. Deficio, which matchup are you most excited for when you look at this?
RNG versus Fnatic. I want to see if Fnatic can take down a second Chinese team, and I also want to see if Fnatic can continue the performance. We should expect some different picks. Jhin, Lee Sin will most likely be a target coming in from RNG, but the way they were team fighting and picking up skirmishes against what is considered one of the best team fighting teams from China. That was just super well played by Fnatic in game 2 and 3.
I also don't think that Royal's going to have the same sort of overly aggressive, especially in that last game when they ended up, when QG ended up between the two turrets in the bottom lane. Really, really sloppy. I think from Royal we can expect, I think, better early game shot calling, less mistakes in the lane swap or fewer mistakes in the lane swap. And Mata is there, right? They're going to have another strong, strong lane to deal with. And MLXG, we saw some nice stuff from him this tournament. And I think we'll continue to see it.
As long as
best jungler in the tournament?
I think he's the best jungler in the tournament, especially now that Swift didn't really show up at all. I'm disappointed about that Rek'Sai in the end. MLXG will be a whole different beast to deal with for Fnatic. And if he gets his hands on Lee Sin's or bans it away, I think there's a big advantage for RNG.
All right, we're going to have to find out how the semifinals play out tomorrow. Gentlemen, thank you very much for keeping me company here on the Expo Desk. Tomorrow, we will be back live from the Spodek Arena. 11,000 people. Check out the VODs over at youtube.com/IEM. Catch up. We've had some hell of exciting games, and I cannot wait to do those BO3s and BO5 tomorrow. Guys, we'll see you then.